हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ प्योर सब्सटेंस। द कंटेंट फॉर द सेम इज प्योर सब्सटेंसेस एंड फेज चेंज प्रोसेस ऑफ प्योर सब्सटेंस, प्रॉपर्टी डायग्राम फॉर द प्योर चेंज और द फेज चेंज प्रोसेस, अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ स्टीम टेबल एंड मोलियर चार्ट विद सुटेबल एग्जाम्पल एंड प्रॉब्लम बेस्ड ऑन द प्योर सब्सटेंस। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू ओनली टॉक अबाउट द प्योर सब्सटेंस एंड फेज चेंज प्रोसेस ऑफ प्योर सब्सटेंस। Now let us start. The objectives for this topic are, first thing is to introduce the concept of pure substance, and next is discuss the physics of phase change process. Now let us start with the introduction to the concept of pure substance. Now what is pure substance? So the pure substance are those that has a fixed chemical composition throughout. So no matter what, if it is miscible or miscible, the chemical composition should be same throughout, or it should be homogeneous throughout. Then only we can say that the given component or the substance is a pure substance. The air is a mixture of several gases, but it is considered to be a pure substance. See, the nitrogen and the gaseous air are considered to be a pure substance. Here the other example, that is a mixture of liquid and gaseous water, is pure substance, but a mixture of liquid and gaseous air is not. Now let us say why they are saying it this way. Now let us take example and try to understand what they mean to say with the pure substance. So when you talk about pure substance, the chemical composition should be same. The chemical composition should be same. So what does that mean? So if I take the example of nitrogen, let's say in a given flask, let's say if suppose there is a nitrogen. Now you take a pocket at various corners. You take a sample pocket at various corners and check their chemical composition. If the chemical composition for these pockets, okay, they are all same, then we can say that it's a pure substance. This is about one chemical composition, that is of nitrogen. The same can be talked about oxygen also. Okay, if I take the oxygen sample, let's say in the given space there is oxygen everywhere. Now if I take a sample at any random places, okay, and again if I check the chemical composition for this sample, and if they are coming same, then what does that mean? It means the given substance is a pure substance. Now similarly, we can take the example of some other cases. Now let us take example of, let's say, air. If I consider air, which I hope all of you know, it's the composition of nitrogen, oxygen and some other gases. The composition is fixed. Nitrogen presents in 78 and this is approximately 21, and rest of the is the other gases. Now again, if I take the same case, if I consider air in this space, and now again if I take sample size everywhere, okay, at various places, and now if suppose this sample size are showing similar chemical composition, then what does that mean? Again, it means that the given substance is a pure substance. Now the same can be said about, let's say, the vapor and water, or the water vapor. Now here also, if suppose there is a water over here and then the vapor around it, now this also can be considered as the pure substance. Why is it so? Now even if I take any random size, okay, they are all going to show the same thing. What is that? It is H2O. okay, that is why this can be considered as a pure substance. Now can we say the same thing about, let's say, the mixture of air and vapor? So let us consider air and vapor. Now in this case, if suppose it's a mixture of air and vapor, let's say this is vapor and this is somewhere air. Now here if I take the sample size at various places, it is going to show a different chemical composition. Okay, that is why this cannot be considered as a pure substance. So I hope you have understood basically what is the pure substance, okay, and how to figure out that any given substance is a pure substance or not. Okay, so the other way of classification is given over here. Okay, the matter itself can be classified by various ways. So this is also one of the ways. Matter is something that occupies the space and possesses the masses, may exist as solid, liquid, and gaseous. Okay, so in this case, there are two ways. Okay, opposite two ways in a nature. One is in the pure substance form, and other one is the mixture form. So what is pure substance? The matter having an invariant chemical composition and distinct property. So the other, the again, they may be element or they can be a compound. So in case of element, they are fundamental substance and cannot be separated into a simpler substances by chemical method. And in case of compound, they can be a substance composed of two or more elements in the fixed proportion, can be separated into a simpler substance and element only by the chemical method. So the other chemical methods and all, we are not going to focus on. We are going to only focus on the pure substance over here. So I hope I have made things clear for you guys about the pure substance from the thermodynamics point of view. Okay, now let us go for the next topic. The next topic is discuss the physics of phase change process. Now, in this case, you have to first of all remember few things. Okay, that the one that you have learned in the physics. Okay, now this is A. Okay, this talks about the molecular structure which is correspond to the solid. Okay, now here the molecular bond between the two molecules, okay, they are quite high. Okay, so that is why the space is less, and that's why we call this as a solid whose density is higher than the liquid. In case of liquid, the molecular bonds are not there. Okay, they are spread out slightly. Okay, they can move around. And in case of gaseous, okay, the molecular bond is almost negligible. Okay, they can move quite freely as compared to that of a liquid. So this thing I hope all of you know. Okay, the arrangement of atoms in the different phases, the molecules are relatively fixed composition or fixed position in case of solid, and groups of molecules move about each other in case of liquid phases, and molecules move about at a random in case of a gaseous phase. This is something that all of you know about the molecular structures in case of solid, liquid, and gaseous. This is something that you need to know, nothing else. Okay, now let us again look at the phase change process of a pure substance. Now in this case, we have to look into the various stages. Okay, the first one comes as a compressed liquid, that is the subcool liquid. Okay, now a substance that is not about to vaporize is called as a compressed liquid. Then comes the natural liquid or the saturated liquid. The liquid that is about to vaporize is called as a saturated liquid. Then the saturated vapor. Now what is saturated vapor? The vapor that is about to condense is your saturated vapor. Then the saturated liquid vapor mixture. Okay, the state at which the liquid and vapor phase coexist in case of a equilibrium, this phase is nothing but your saturated liquid vapor mixture. Now the next one is superheated one, where the vapor that is not about to condense or not about to saturated vapor, that kind of vapors are superheated one. Now we are going to look into each type, okay, that we have seen here one by one. Now let us consider the first example where the compressed liquid or the subcool liquid. Now this one is the subcool liquid. Here you can see the example is given over here. In case of a, let's say, piston cylinder arrangement, the water is taken, let's say the water taken at a 1 atmospheric pressure and 20 degrees Celsius. Okay, the water exists in a liquid phase in this case. So it's a simple case. Okay, so even though I am heating this composition, even in that case the water is staying in this composition where my pressure stays at 1 atmospheric pressure and my temperature is at 20 degrees Celsius. So obviously any water that stays around, that you can see around, is your compressed liquid, or you can call it as a subcooled liquid. Now the next stage is there where my water has reached to 100 degrees Celsius. Now I hope all of you know that corresponding to pressure equal to 1 atmospheric, the saturation temperature, what is saturation temperature? It is the temperature at which the boiling takes place. It is the temperature at which the phase change takes place. Is approximately 99.97, so we consider this as 100 degrees Celsius. So at 1 atmospheric pressure and 100 degrees Celsius, water exists as a liquid. Now here you have to understand there is no start of phase changes. Okay, the phase change has not started over in this case. Okay, that is why we are calling this as a saturated liquid phase. So even though the temperature is 100 degrees Celsius, okay, not even a single molecule has changed its phase. So that state is your saturated liquid state. Now next one is this one here, the third stage, that is the saturated liquid vapor mixture. So what happens after this point, even if you keep adding heat, what happens, the molecules will start separating, okay, and then the phase change will start occurring there, okay. As more heat is transferred, part of saturated liquid vaporizes, okay. So what happens, the liquid and vapor mixture stays together. So pressure, at pressure equal to 1 atmospheric and temperature 100 degrees Celsius, the liquid and vapor both will coexist. Now this is your liquid vapor mixture. In the fourth stage, okay, again I have considered my pressure, and my pressure is not changed here. Okay, why is the pressure is not changed? You have to observe here that the piston moves upward. Okay, since my piston is moving upward, okay, I can assume that my pressure remains constant in this case. Okay, and so as my temperature. In the fourth stage, what happens? All the liquid, okay, or all the water has converted itself into a steam or vapor. Now this stage, okay, is again called as a saturated vapor stage. So here you can say, and until the last drop of liquid is vaporized, that part is your saturated vapor. Now what is this state? These two states, okay, they are very spontaneous, or what you can say, they are depending on time. Okay, even a small amount of heat is added in this case, okay, it gets converted to a mixture phase. And even if a small amount of heat is removed from this phase, okay, it gets converted to again a mixture state. So staying at these two states is very difficult for any practical cases. Okay. Now the last one is obviously the superheated one. Now even if I keep on adding the temperature, even if I keep on adding the heat in this case, okay, my temperature is going to increase. Now this increased temperature, okay, let's say at 300 degrees Celsius, is my superheated vapor. Now this is all about the phase change that we have tried to understand with the help of example. Now same can be seen if I want to draw a TS diagram. Now let us try to draw a TS diagram for the same. So here, let's say my temperature versus, instead of volume, I am going to consider enthalpy. So what happened, initially my temperature was somewhere here, okay, 20 degrees Celsius. So let's say at this point, if I start giving heat, okay, then what will happen? Obviously, its temperature has increased. Now it has increased to what level? It has increased to a level that is saturated. Let's call this 100 degrees Celsius. Okay. So this point, okay, is your point number one that I have considered previously. Okay. Then it goes to point number two over here. Now this is your subcool state, okay, or this one is your subcool state. Now at this point number 2, even if I keep on adding heat, what will happen? The temperature won't increase. The temperature remains same. Only the heat added is increased. Now this part is my sensible heat. Okay, the sensible heat is added in this part, and in this part it is my latent heat that is added. So again, this point number 2 is your saturated liquid point. This is your saturated vapor liquid mixture. Okay. And this point number 3, or you can say any point number 3 over here, is the saturated liquid vapor mixture. This point number 4 over here, okay, is nothing but your saturated vapor. Now even if I keep on adding heat, what will happen? Okay. Now my temperature will increase. So this point that we talked about, let's say at 300 degrees Celsius, this point here is, let's say call this point number 5. Now this is your superheated vapor. So try and understand, the heat that we are talking about is the sensible heat from 1 to 2, then from 2 to 4 there is a latent heat, and again from 4 to 5 there is a sensible heat. Now what is this sensible heat and latent heat is all about? So the sensible heat is one which responsible for increasing temperature. So all the heat that you are giving, can understand the, all the heat that you are giving in this case is responsible to increase the kinetic energy of molecules. Okay, so this is the sensible heat. Now, in case of a latent heat, what is happening? All the heat that you are giving is responsible to break the molecular bond. So now, in this case, in case of latent heat, all the molecular bonds are break. So that is why it converts from liquid to vapor state. So this is all about the sensible heat and latent heat, which is there in case of a phase change. Now let us see the same thing with the help of example again. So the best example here is the pressure cooker. Again, I hope all of you know why do we go for pressure cooker here. So if I take again an example of a pressure cooker, you can consider an example of pressure cooker. If I take a potato, okay, if I keep it in a beaker and if I keep on heating it, okay, let's say it's kept inside of water. Okay, this is the water over here. If I keep on heating it, what is the possibility to what temperature this may reach? Okay, this may reach to only 100 degrees Celsius. Now, if I consider the same with the help of, let's say, a pressure cooker. Okay, if I take a pressure cooker in this case, now what has happened here? Since my pressure is increasing, okay, that means my corresponding saturated temperature also increases. So the boiling will not take place at 100 degrees Celsius. Okay, it will take place at 150 degrees Celsius. Let's say example. So this is at 1 atmospheric pressure. Okay, and this will be at slightly higher than 1 atmospheric pressure. So that is why the potato that is kept inside the, let's say, pressure cooker, okay, will get cooked quicker. Okay, the time required is reduced in this case. So the time required is reduced in this case because of the increase in pressure over here. So this is all the concept that we use in case of a pressure cooker. Okay, the same can be seen over here with this example. Okay, it's the same thing that we have seen, temperature versus the heat added. Now here they have started from minus 40. So from minus 40, again the sensible heat will be added till it gets to 0 degrees Celsius. Now from 0 solid, okay, or ice to 0 degrees Celsius liquid, there will be a latent heat addition. Okay, they call this the latent heat of fusion. Then again from 0 to 100 degrees Celsius, there is a sensible heat, okay, which is again given by mcp delta t. And again at 100 degrees Celsius, there is a latent heat, and from 100 to, let's say, 130, there is a superheating there. Now the same thing, same diagram is explained earlier. Now here what they are talking about, if we come ulta. Now instead of going from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, let us come from 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. What will happen? In this case, so they are saying, if the entire process between state 1 and 5 described in this figure is reversed by cooling the water while maintaining the pressure at the same value, the water will go back to state 1, retracing the same path, and in the so doing, the amount of heat released will exactly match the amount of heat added during the entire heating process. So that is what they are saying here. Even if I go from 1 to 5 or 5 to 1, okay, the trace will be same, the path will be same, and the amount of heat added or heat release will be same in this. Now let us look at few of the important terminologies, that is the saturated temperature and saturated pressure. Now what does that mean? Now the saturated term itself is very important. Now this is something that describes that enough is enough. Now the same kind of what we call condition is explained over here. The temperature at which the water starts boiling depends on the pressure. Therefore, if the pressure is mixed, so is the boiling temperature. The water boils at 100 degrees Celsius at 1 atmospheric pressure. Now what is the saturated temperature? The temperature at which the pure substance changes phase at a given pressure is my saturated temperature. Okay. Now similarly, what is saturated pressure? The pressure at which the pure substance changes phase at a given temperature is my saturated pressure. Now here this also can be explained with the help of this diagram over here. As you can see, this is my Tsat, this is my Psat. So for this 100 degrees Celsius, if I try to draw this diagram, okay, so this will come approximately at what pressure? So obviously this will come approximately 100 kPa. What is 1 atmospheric pressure? So it is 1 into 10 raised to 5 newton per meter square. So that is approximately 100 kilopascal. So at 100 degree Celsius or at 100 kilopascal, the boiling will take place if my temperature reaches to 100 degree Celsius. So similarly, this curve can be seen for the water. Okay, it is almost a parabolic curve. At, you can see here, even at 150 degree Celsius, my pressure need to be approximately 5 times that of this one here. Approximately it should be around 500 kPa, that is 5 bar. So this can be seen and understood with the kind of curve that is given for the P side and the T side. Again, the latent heat, we talked about the amount of energy absorbed or released during the phase change process. The latent of fusion is amount of energy absorbed during the melting. It is equivalent to the amount of energy released during the freezing. And the latent heat of vaporization is amount of energy absorbed during the vaporization and is equivalent to the energy released during the condensation. Okay, we have seen this with the help of previous diagram. Okay, where is the latent heat of fusion and vaporization? So the fusion is the energy required to break the bond from solid to liquid, and the latent of vaporization is the amount of energy required to break the bond, break the molecular bond from liquid to gaseous state. The magnitude of latent heat depends on the temperature and the pressure at which the phase change occurs. At 1 atmospheric, this is very important. Okay, this term, the fusion is 330 kilojoule per kg and latent heat of vaporization is approximately 2250 kilojoule per kg. So obviously this length is slightly more as compared to this one. So the consequences is given here for the T side and P side. The variation of temperature of the fruits and vegetables with the pressure during the vacuum cooling from 25 degrees Celsius to 0 degrees Celsius. This is 25 degrees Celsius at 100 kPa. Now what they have done, they have reduced the pressure, and in that case obviously my temperature has reduced. The end of cooling is at 0 degree Celsius at 0.61 kPa. So this is vacuum cooling they talk about. Similarly can be seen with this diagram. This was the earlier stage where the ice was made by evacuating the air space in a water tank. So they consider this. Let us take this water tank over here, and somehow if I can reduce or remove the air which is there in the water tank, what will happen? The pressure will drop, and then since the pressure is dropped, okay, my T side also will drop. Okay, and slowly this ice will be formed over a surface of a water. Now this was the method that was used in 1775. Again, this is the vacuum cooling they call about. Okay, where the air is evacuated from the given space. Now that is it in this topic. Thank you for watching this video.